Hi everyone, OCA here. All Denon Marantz home cinema receivers contain a calibration file for the standard Audyssey ACM1HB microphone that comes with them. In this video, I'll show you how to hack this calibration file. You will not even need a calibrated microphone. All you will need is a free Room EQ Wizard software installed and the MultEQ app, which is like $20 for iPhones and I think can even be found for free for Android phones. Place your Audyssey microphone at the central listening position and at ear height and plug it to your AVR. Start a standard Audyssey measurement from your app. Make the minimum 3 measurements without moving the microphone and end the measurements there. Only after the 3rd measurement it gives you the option to end the measurement. Or if you have time you can complete all 8 measurements, but we only need 1. Then send the calibration to your AVR like you normally would and send a copy of the .ady file to your PC. I have explained how to do that in my previous videos, you can easily find, but it's very straightforward. Then connect your PC to your AVR through HDMI. Unplug the microphone from your AVR and plug it into your PC's microphone input. Open REW software, use either ASIO or Java exclusive drivers to play and record sweeps. Measure front left speaker 0 to 24,000 Hz and any sweep length is okay. Once you have the ADY file on your PC, open your web browser, go to JSON Online Editor. Any Google search, it will come up the first hit, this one. And with the ADY file that you saved in your PC, just drop it onto the JSON screen, like so. Then you will see all the detected channels. My system has 9 plus 1 channels, 5.1.4, and go to channel 0, which is your front left channel, and you will see that you will have 3 response data there because we made only 3 measurements. All of them are supposed to be the same because we didn't move the microphone. The important point here is not moving the microphone during these measurements and also when measuring it with REW with your PC. Only where the microphone is plugged will change, but the microphone will stay put. So then, this is the measurement data for the first microphone position. This is for the second one. This is for the third one. Any one of these will do. They are all the same. So just copy, right click and copy and open Notepad on your PC and paste all the data. Delete this last square bracket. Go to the top of the file and delete the opening square bracket here. And at the beginning of this file, just paste this exactly the same, which you will find in the comment section under the video. You need this header for REW to understand what is coming. And that's all. Just save this as whatever you need to call front left 0. Once you've done that, open Room EQ Wizard. Drag and drop the text file you have just created. This one. Fit to data. So this is your front left speaker measurement measured by Audyssey and hacked from your MultEQ app. Now you will also have a measurement that you have done for the same speaker with REW. So I have done it here before. Let's just get that. Actually, I have imported all these 3 measurements just to make sure. If you will remember, there were 3 response data for each channel. I have imported to REW all these 3 just to be certain that we are importing the right file. So here are the imported files. As you see, response 0, response 1 and response 2 are almost the same, except for some differences below the audible range, below 20 Hertz. The sound pressure level is randomly chosen by REW. I think it gave them an offset of 120 dB. But these are the measurements. And this is the REW measurement I have done when the microphone was in exactly the same place. Anyway, let's first take a vector average. But you don't need to import all 3. Just 1 is enough. But if you do, then take a vector average, and then you don't need the others. This you can call your front left Audyssey. Okay, and this is the front left I measured when the microphone was exactly at the same place with REW. Let's also remove any smoothing from that. Yeah. Now, align their sound pressure levels with align SPL. Let's bring them both to 75 dB. Alignment center 1 kHz, alignment span 5 octaves. Okay, and as you see, now they are on top of each other. And as you can see from the similarity, the import and everything else is correct. This is exactly how Audyssey measures. Now let's see, because the microphone was the same, the location of the microphone was exactly the same. So what are the differences between these two measurements? To see that more properly, let's apply 1.48 smoothing to both of the measurements, to both Audyssey 1/48. So as you see, it is almost the same everywhere. I mean, there are ups and downs, but when there is a loss here, there is a gain here. So these are not mic calibration. It's obvious. It's just some measurement errors. But here, there is a huge difference, which definitely is a microphone calibration inside the receiver that is being applied to Audyssey measurement. The same microphone when REW measured it, the same speaker. This is when Audyssey measured it. So since they must be the same, Audyssey measurement has been applied some microphone calibration file. To find out what that is, you have to divide with trace arithmetic. Let's make it larger. Front left Audyssey to front left REW. Absolute division. Zero regularization. Generate. And if you'll see under the screen, because it's a calibration file, it's at 0 dB. Okay, and when you apply, for example, 1/6 smoothing to that, you will see that here these ups and downs are just noise. Probably you have to see that from 20 to 20. So here I would say they don't apply anything up to here. And from 5K, there is a negative 2 dB application, and after somewhere around 9000 hertz, they apply up to 20,000 10 dB boost to Audyssey microphone high frequencies. Okay, when you know that, you will understand better the response graphs that Audyssey is producing for you. I tried to measure this with a U-Mic 2 calibrated microphone. I tried to put the microphone at exactly the same place. It's never very accurate though. You can't do perfectly same location. I found out that microphone actually needs only 7 dB calibration here in the high frequency. And it needs some calibration in the bass frequencies as well. So this calibration, I think, is batch produced for an average of these microphones that they are sending with their receivers. And it's automatically applying 10 dB boost to every one of them. Mine, for example, I don't know yours is the same or any different, but mine needs only 7 dB. So this is not very accurate, but it brings some sort of accuracy to the Audyssey microphone. If you have a calibrated microphone, you can create a correct calibration file and by custom curve editing embed it into Audyssey correction. However, there is no need for that. If you already have a calibrated microphone and if you're okay with measuring your system with it, you can optimize Audyssey correction a lot better and more efficiently, which is a subject of another video. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.